animals. This video is another part of artificial vegetative propagation. In last video, I made you understand about cutting and grafting. Now I'm going to explain layering and tissue culture. I'm going to make you understand layering and tissue culture. Once again, I will tell you, these all are very easy to understand. Only you need to remember their steps. Anything in your life, whenever you plan for anything or when you are studying anything, if you are studying step by step, if you are learning anything step by step, it helps you to memorize it well. So go through step wise and listen to me carefully. I am sure that at the last of the video, you'll be able to answer all the questions related to these topics. So first one is layering. For example, let us start with the examples today. For example, jasmine or bougainvillea or grapes, we can take anything. You know, these plants, when they grow bigger, when become they bigger, one of the part of the mother plant, these stems are very they are not hard, they are soft, so they start bending. So what farmers or gardeners, what they do, they take this part, वो क्या करते हैं कि वो जो part bend हो गया है उसे थोड़ा खींच कर soil के अंदर लगा देते हैं और उसे गीली मिट्टी से ढक देते हैं. What they do? They take this part, so inside the soil and that cover, and then cover with the moist mud or moist soil. Slowly, you know what happened? Adventitious root starts developing from this part. And at the same time, when the root develops, a new branch arises from here. Then when the new branch arises, then they cut this plant or they divide this plant from the mother plant. They cut and separate these two plants, and in that process or in that way they get another new plant, and this is continued. When they need to get, suppose if any plant, jasmine plant is very good, all these qualities are there, whatever is desired, or grapes, good trees there, good plant is there, providing lots of grapes, sweet grapes. So obviously everybody wish to get the same grapes again and again. So in that way they grow so many plants of the same characteristics, because this is the asexual method of propagation. That is why whatever part is taken from the mother plant and grown, it is going to provide you same kind of fruits. So this was layering. This process is what called layering. Now let us start the tissue culture. What do we mean by the tissue culture? You must be knowing, no, plants do not have nervous system. What do they have? They have hormones, and these hormones are responsible for their growth and development. And the plant hormones are called phytohormones. Plant ke hormones ko hum kya kehte hain? Phytohormones kehte hain. So in tissue culture, you know what happened? This is a very good method. Tissue culture is also, you know, known as micropropagation. Ise hum na micropropagation bhi kehte hain. Yes, don't forget. This tissue culture is very good for preventing the loss of plant or to protect the plants from extinction. ऐसा कोई भी प्लांट जो कि एक्सटिंक्ट होने वाला है, उसे हम, उस प्लांट को हम इनसे लुप्त होने से बचा लेते हैं टिश्यू कल्चर के प्रोसेस के द्वारा. लाइक क्राइसेंथेमम इज देयर, एस्पेरेगस इज देयर, दिस ऑल आर ग्रोन वंस दे ऑल वर एट द लेवल ऑफ एक्सटिंक्शन. सो हाउ दिस इज डन. अ पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट, अ टिश्यू, a small quantity of the cells, you can say, taken from which part? You know, growing part. From the growing part, small part of the tissue is taken, and that tissue is kept in न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम. What do we mean by this न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम? यानी कि इसे एक हॉर्मोन में रख दिया जाता है. ऑल दोज हॉर्मोन विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डिविजन ऑफ द सेल. देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फाइटो हॉर्मोन्स. आप जब क्लास 10 में आएंगे तो आप इसे पढ़ेंगे नर्वस सिस्टम में. ये फाइटो हॉर्मोन्स डिफरेंट डिफरेंट हैं. कुछ डिविजन के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, कुछ ग्रोथ के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, कुछ फ्लावर्स एंड फ्रूट्स के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, कुछ प्लांट्स के ग्रोथ को रोकने के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स. बट यू शुड नो दैट इन अ ग्लास दीज स्मॉल टिश्यू इज केप्ट इन द न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम. लेकिन एक कंट्रोल कंडीशन में मीन्स वॉट? वो कंडीशन कंट्रोल क्यों होना चाहिए? उनको वैसा ही कंडीशन दिया जाता है जो नेचुरल कंडीशन हो. जो अगर वो नेचुरली ग्रो करते, जो उनको कंडीशन चाहिए होता, जितनी सनलाइट, जितना मॉइस्चर, वही कंडीशन प्रोवाइड किया जाता है इनको. आफ्टर समटाइम्स यू नो व्हाट हैपन, दिस टिश्यू स्टार्ट ग्रोइंग, डिवाइडिंग एंड दे बिकम कैलस. देन दिस कैलस इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू अनदर ग्लास ट्यूब. This callus is transferred to another glass tube. This callus will become shoot. Then after some time, ये जो nutrient medium है, जो phyto hormone है जिसमें इसे डाला गया, इनकी वजह से बहुत short period of time में इनमें shoot develop करता है and slowly their growth of leaves, growth of shoot start developing. Then finally, it is removed and they get converted into plantlet. ये plantlet में convert हो जाते हैं. फिर इन्हें इस medium से निकाल करके और naturally vas में, soil में, moist soil में sow कर दिया जाता है for their natural growth. So I hope you people have understood this tissue culture also. Why it is told tissue culture? Tissue culture means a part of cells, group of cells, means tissue is taken and cultured. You know, this group of cells which is taken also called explant. इसे हम क्या कहते हैं? Explant कहते हैं. Okay, and this explant is cultured in medium, nutrient medium, for getting a new plant. So that is why this process is called tissue culture. I'm sure that you people have understood it well. If you have understood it well, then I will request you to share, subscribe and write the comment. And wait for my new updates. Thank you all of you.